just watching over me, and suddenly I'm melting into you. There's nothing left to prove, baby, all we need is just to breathe. Caught up in the touch, slow and then we rush. Baby, isn't that the way the love's supposed to be? I can hear you breathe. Just Valentine's Day, so every once in a while I just need a love song.
This sort of tells the love story about how you see someone, and it might cause it. In fact, you said something earlier, Greg, about seeing Anne from across the room, and it causes some sort of intuition and physical response in your body, and then you might do something to introduce yourself and say something that may be silly or kind, and that makes that connection. And then you see possibility, and then maybe develop a friendship that then becomes a slippery slope. And as you go along here, it talks about being exposed and, you know, being vulnerable in the relationship, and then sort of being in it. The rest of the four are about, you know, dancing up a storm and kind of being involved in. The round one down there is called I Love You to the Moon and Back. And then, like I talked about, bittersweet love, and then maybe a healing journey in the end, right? So that's sort of the journey, but the cards, I'll say a little bit more about it. So that's
Well, I'm really glad to be here. My name is Joëlle Lydon. If you told me 6 years ago that I'd be standing in front of you talking to you about love and relationships, I would have thought you were absolutely crazy. I was a disaster at relationships. I was unsuccessful after unsuccessful after unsuccessful relationship. I was the poster child for the one who could really mess it up. And about 6 years ago, I got my heart broken, I think devastated. I was on my knees, and it felt like it's actually been for the very last time. And I made a decision while I was down on my knees, because, you know, you have nowhere to go but up when you're down there, which was to question my beliefs around relationships and how women are supposed to show up and how men are supposed to show up and how the whole thing's supposed to go, because in my past I've gone with that, you know, love, marriage, baby carriage formula. Do you remember that one? It didn't work. Mine looked very much more complicated. And at the point where I was down on my knees, I realized that whatever beliefs I was holding to be true around relationships and about partnership, and for me with men, although this applies to all relationships because love doesn't know gender, right? Love just
keep my eyes open, I can love her for this love. Giving away promises I know that I can't keep. Nothing fills the blackness that has seeped into my chest. I need you to remind me that I am forsaking all the rest. Just to reach you. Just to reach you. All I reach you. Come to my window. Crawl inside. Wait by the light of the
a toy, like, wow, score, right? It becomes an enhancement to an already amazing experience. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So it's not like my life depends on me meeting Mr. or Mrs. Right. It's really about how can I create the kind of life that I would want so that the person that I meet is an enhancement to what I'm already experiencing.